Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And this tutorial is going to be a little bit different. So in this one, I'm going to show you how you can add some spiral and anisotropic noise in your metallic objects in Substance Painter. So I'm sure when you model a utensil like this, there's always some spiral noise like this in the inside part or the bottom part. So I'm going to tell you how you can add this in Substance Painter. So it is a pretty easy procedure. Let's add a material here. I'm just going to take a fill layer. So because we are not going to texture this asset, I'm just going to show you how you can add that noise. So I'm going to increase the metallic and just keep it like this. Something like this. So to add that texture, what you need to do is you have to take another fill layer and add a black mask here and add another fill. And in this grayscale section, just go to your procedurals and here you'll see this anisotropic radial. Select this and drop it here. And now you can see that your texture is visible. But there's a difference between this and this, as you can see. We don't want any color information here. So what you need to do is you have to go to your fill layer and turn off your color and your normal and height. We're going to just play with the metallic and the roughness part. I'm going to increase the metallic all the way to 1. And now you can see that your texture is fading away. So to adjust the opacity, what you can do is you can increase or decrease the roughness. Something like this. So I think this looks fine. And to adjust this texture map onto this circular part, what you can do is you can go back to this anisotropic radial and here in this UV view, you can scale this. So press shift and just scale it down and place it here like this. And as you can see that it is still affecting all the other areas. So to remove all these parts, what you need to do is you can go to UV wrap and set it to none. And your texture will always be in this part, as you can see. And then you can always play with the roughness and the metallic part. So this looks more realistic. And for these part, you can use this anisotropic noise. And I'm going to try this one as well. So just take another fill layer and here add another black mask and a fill. Now select this one and drop here. And for this one, we need to increase the tiling. I'm going to take something like 15 or 10. And again, go back, turn off color, normal and height, and increase the metallic and roughness. So that's how you can add anisotropic noise. And as you can see that our anisotropic noise is overlapping the spiral. So what you can do is you can put this in a group and add a black mask to this group. Then go to your polygon fill and let's select the UVs where we want to apply this texture. So I'm going to check this UV chunk fill and select these parts. And if you think the tiling is not enough, you can always go back here and increase the tiling like this. I think 15 is fine, and you can increase or decrease the balance. And the noise parameter. So you can play with all these settings and you can achieve the desired result. This looks better. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, then make sure to drop a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.